Greetings and salutations, one and all. Welcome to another exciting week of Siege of the Empire. I'm your host, Jordan, aka Mankey Games, and it is February 3rd. Happy February, everybody. February 3rd, 2017, and this is, I think this is episode 31 or 30. I don't know. I have to get caught up on YouTube before I can tell you for sure. That's all I know. I'd like to thank everybody for being here. It's going to be a wonderful time. Let me go ahead and, hey, look, everything looks great. Awesome. Let me go ahead and see if anyone is on Discord yet. Just a couple of people. Looks like we're still waiting for a few people to get their happy little butts in here, but that's okay. I'm going to turn them on and we're going to have a chat and see who's doing what. Hello, everyone.
Hello.
And by everyone, I mean Megan and
Yay!
Brian.
Yay! The best people Yay. Are here.
The only ones that matter. Surprise, this is actually just going to be your guys' show. I told everybody else not even to bother showing up.
Awesome.
Obviously
they will hopefully be here within a few minutes, because I don't like people not showing up and not telling me. Although Jackson will not be here, probably.
Aww.
He's got stuff going on with his job thing today, so he will most likely not be here. But there's no excuse for those other three people. In the meantime, Brian, tell us about how your week went.
It's been not great.
That's not good.
Yeah, no, it sucks. Trying to get a new job, but keep getting like the runaround type of thing. It sucks, but whatever. Doesn't really matter because I just bought For Honor Gold Edition today, so I'm happy and don't care.
I like how nice. It's trying to get a new job, but I'm gonna buy this video game.
Well, I still have a current job. I'm just trying to get a second one.
Gotcha. Makes sense.
Trying to upgrade in the world, but I don't know. My current job is still really nice.
I told myself from a very early age that I was never going to work two jobs. And so far, I have never had to work two jobs.
So. I don't need to. I just want to, because extra money's nice.
Yeah. I mean, I agree with you. Well, at least, that's not the shittiest of news, right? There are much worse things that could be occurring.
Yeah, exactly. I'm still alive, I'm still happy. And I have D&D today. So, you know, it's pretty good still.
I mean, maybe.
Nah, still pretty good.
Yeah, also, congratulations, Nightbot is set up.
Hooray!
I have a bunch of different ones as well. So like, if you do this, look at that.
Cool.
And if you do this, and also this one will change, obviously. But I have that one set up for RimWorld currently.
Nice.
It's way easier than it used to be with Nightbot. It's just a browser thing that just runs in the background.
Yeah, so, I was fairly certain it was, like, no big deal.
It used to be, like, a thing you had to install on your computer and shit, but... So we're good now. We good. We Gucci. Megan, how's your week been? Tell us all about it.
My week's been busy. A lot of things occurring this week. Busy at work, and then I've been dedicating a lot of volunteer hours to a bunch of different things this week. So that's been happening. What else at work? The kids had Sushi Fest this week. And also, two of my kids almost burned the building down today. That was fun times.
Oh, hey, Will's here.
Hi, Will.
Hi. Hello.
Now the top three best people are here. Mm-hmm. See? We're all good.
Indeed. It looks like Liam will be joining us soon. Although it looks like Jackson might be joining us soon as well, unless he's just on his phone. But anyway, continue, Megan. I'm sorry.
No, I'm pretty sure that covers it. It's been my week.
Just a lot of work, huh?
A lot of work. Apparently, I learned 12-year-olds cannot be trusted to make popcorn without supervision.
Yep.
That seems legitimate.
Yep. And yeah, that's about it.
Fantastic. I assume yesterday you were busy doing things?
Yeah, so I had a school event, which I was busy with, and then I got a call and I had to go do a thing, a family thing came up, so I had to run off and go do that unexpectedly.
Didn't miss much.
Yeah, so I heard. Will filled me in when everyone else ignored me, so that's cool.
He filled you in, and so I didn't feel the need to, because that would be rude of me to assume that Will didn't fill you in properly.
I know.
Speaking of, Megan, what are you doing tomorrow?
That's a great question, actually. I don't think I'm doing a whole lot of anything.
Great. So the correct answer is you're playing Pit People with me all day tomorrow.
Yes! Yes, we are.
We should play Pit People tonight, actually, after this.
Yes. Hold on. I will start downloading it now.
Yeah, install it right now. Will didn't want to buy it, so I've been waiting to play until you were available.
I mean, yes. I am interested to buy it, just maybe not quite.
Yeah. Is it more than two people? Can we play more than
two
people?
No, it is only two people. Yeah. It is only two people. So, yeah, I bought Pit People. This week I had some different work priorities at my actual work.
Oh, yeah, you're training involved, or something, right?
Yeah, it involved having to show up an hour early for 2 days this week, so I was pretty fucking conked this week.
Did you get to leave an hour early?
No. Same time. Leave at the same time. You just show up an hour early. So, like, you do 9 hours of work as opposed to 8 hours of work.
That's stupid. Do you get paid more for it?
Yeah, I'm still hourly, so... I get that whole extra 1 hour of pay, which...
It'd be nice, you know, to get paid for times you stay after. Mm-hmm. It sounds like a fun thing.
Yeah, well, you made the mistake going salary, so,
And also being a teacher. And but that's
also
fine.
Being a teacher. I mean, that was mistake number one. We weren't going to bring that up.
I know.
Because I have a lot of respect for our teachers, but, you know, that was kind of your first mistake.
The good pay was not one of them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's not why anyone does it, I'm fairly certain.
Well, not on this continent.
Right, yeah, exactly.
Yeah, this is a true story. Other places actually are...
I've heard Japanese teachers make a lot of money, actually.
Also Eastern Europe.
Eastern Europe
makes a lot of money, too.
Yeah. Eastern European. And funny enough, they do really well in testing. Mm-hmm. Curious. And curious.
Yeah.
If you pay the teachers enough money to make them give a shit, they'll actually teach your students. It's amazing.
Right.
It's an incredible concept.
Weird.
Yeah, I know, right?
Happens. Treat them well, and maybe they'll do better at their job. Who knows?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Sorry, continue.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I didn't really have anything, but Will, tell us about your week, sir. How have you been? What's been going on with you?
My week's been alright. I've been playing the Crypt of the Necrodancer DLC.
Yes, so good.
Yeah. So, finally defeated it with the new character. So, now trying the new fifth stage for all the characters, and that is a pain in the ass. So.
Damn, so you're actually like real good at the game, huh?
I am reasonable.
No, the answer is yes. He's being humble. The answer is yes. He's too good at this stupid game.
Hmm.
But yes, I have almost remade it 100%. So,
well,
yeah,
fantastic. Congratulations, I guess, are in order.
Yes, thank you very much.
achievement.
I mean, I could never probably do that, so yeah, I feel like that is a valid achievement that should be congratulated. Liam, tell us about you, sir. It's good to see you.
I have a follow-up job interview on Monday, so that's exciting.
This is a secondary interview?
Yay for Liam.
Yep. Yeah, second interviews are good.
Absolutely. So, I'm pretty hyped about that. I have been unemployed since before we started playing this game, so at this point, having an income again sounds like a superpower.
Wow,
I know that one.
I didn't know that was a thing, but considering this game is, God, almost a year and a half old,
Right?
Isn't it, like, almost 2 years old?
Not quite that
No, we started in October.
Yeah, October is when we started.
Yeah.
Cry.
Yeah.
Getting there.
Getting there. We're getting there, yeah.
Almost time for married.
It's almost, yeah, exactly. it's almost time to put a ring on it. Well, that's great. Anything else going on, sir? Are you feeling well? How cold is it up there now?
It's typical. Oh, right, it's February now. It's a bit cold for February, but at least that means we can skate on the canal now.
Fantastic. Imagining solid blocks of ice that don't go in my drink is weird. that's.
You mean like what's on my car right now? Cause
yeah, no, I had to like, I almost thought about wearing long johns the other day because it was like 40 something all day. And I was like, man, I might have to like get winter clothes out. I am still on the Uber Eats train. Actually, today I got my food from Tropical Smoothie Cafe. No, I'm not sponsored. I'm just saying that. I got a sunrise sunset smoothie that I've currently about half finished. It's fucking delicious and was like $4.
Smoothies made it to you in time? That's interesting.
Oh yeah, no, it was very frozen when it got here. In fact, it's still mostly frozen. This place is amazing that I just got it from, though. They're really inexpensive, and they sent me, I got a Jamaican jerk wrap, they just literally sent me a whole banana, and the smoothie. And that was my dinner. That's what I fucking ate. It was amazing.
Okay.
Throwing a banana? Like, why?
So my options were, like, fruit medley, something with oats, and whole fruit. And I chose whole fruit, and they just threw a banana in there for me. Just, like, a whole banana. And it's been a long time since I ate just, like, a whole banana without, like, putting it on something or putting something on it. But, yeah, no, it was pretty good. I remembered, it reminded me how much I actually like bananas.
Americans.
Yeah, that...
So...
Do you not just eat fruit from time to time?
Do you understand how expensive fruit is? Like, twice the price of normal food. So, no. I don't.
Yeah, that's only because your normal food prices are skewed as well.
Yeah, exactly.
No, I do not eat a whole lot of fruit.
I live in an Arctic wasteland. We still have fruit. I'm practically vegetarian.
But Canadian, I don't think that counts.
I get that a lot.
Yeah, no, I'm sure that you do. I'm sure that everybody gets that a lot. What else? Bought Pit People. Excited to play some of that. And
downloaded.
In between this game last week and now, I believe actually on last Saturday is when it occurred. I named the cat, or I should say Jessica named the cat. So the new baby kitty is not named Baby Kitty. She is named Fife. Phife.
Good choice.
In remembrance of Fife Dog, who died last year. And for those who don't know Fife Dog, I suggest you go up and look a band, Tribe Called Quest, and buy all of their music and listen to it, because it's incredible. And that was her choice on the cat's name, and I thought that was a great idea. So...
Forever and always, Baby Kitty.
Well, see, that's the thing, is they all respond to that, because that's what I call all of them. Oh, right. When I come home from work, it's Baby Kitty 1, 2, and 3, because the oldest, then the middle, then the youngest. So they probably assume that's their name anyway.
Yeah, that seems right.
Yep, totally.
So, I think that's about all that happened. Oh, and I finally monetized my videos on YouTube. I hadn't done that because, like, there's a lot of dumb shit that goes into that sometimes. But due to a recent upsurge in views, like, this statistic surprised me, because every now and then I'll log into YouTube and just look at my analytics. And one of the most interesting things that surprised me is, over the past 28 days, 27,444 minutes of view time on my channel. That's a lot.
Yeah, that's a lot.
It's like, rad. Yeah. So I was like, huh.
That's several hours worth per day. What are people watching?
Yeah, I don't know, but they're watching it. So that's what was important, I think. So I decided that it's at a point now where I can justify, perhaps, because it's not like, here's my other thing. It's not like the people aren't seeing ads. YouTube's gonna play the ads no matter what.
Money for it or not.
So why not get 55% of that revenue? So that's what I did. I'll let you know when I make my first dollar, which will probably be in like 3 weeks.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
But hey, you know what? It's that much closer to the dream, right?
Yeah, much closer.
That much, ever slightly, minusculely closer to the dream. And that's basically all I got. The only one who is not in attendance that I was unaware was not going to be in attendance is Dalton. Jackson is doing work stuff today, so he will not be joining us. But that's okay, because we have the required four, and sans Dalton and Jackson, perhaps things will actually get done in this session. It'll be amazing. That was honestly
the pressure's off now.
Honestly, any two of you could be missing, and I would have said that because it's just funny.
Good cover.
Yeah, exactly. Besides the transition of there was some bad juju going on, real quick recap. Last session, you guys decided that, well, since you ran away the first time, maybe perhaps you should go take care of what you need to take care of with the Aboleth, who was lurking in the sewer systems of Nuln. And you, the party, along with a paladin, Sergeant Dashhound, ventured into the sewer systems and decided to retrace your steps back to where the Aboleth originally resided. After some searching and some survival rolling and making sure that everybody was okay and, you know, didn't contract dysentery or something, you guys were able to track down a small kind of gathering of these fishmen. After a highly successful ambush, you began your journey again, and you discovered this strange creature to which nobody could really identify, but it did look like it had a relationship similarity, perhaps, with the Aboleth, with the like tentacles on the face, and we all know what the creature looks like, and you guys had engaged in attempting to break down his impenetrable barrier. However, in the meantime, he had summoned a few more fishmen to waylay you, but after they inevitably failed in their task, because you are all hardened adventurers, after some taunting, he began to reveal some of his power to you. And as well, at the very end of the session, Aelin, you discovered that the magic that is protecting him was starting to wobble and strain, as if perhaps it were running out of juice. And we were in initiative order, but I think that for now, until we like really get started, I wanna kind of get a good bearing on what everybody's thinking and where everybody's like going with this, because the action is kind of in between right now. So we'll start at the top again. So Farron, also, I hope that's roll 20 having issues, correct? Does everybody have connection to server interrupted? Okay, good. Yeah. Roll 20 is having issues. Good. Not me. Awesome. So Farron, you during the fight, during the fight, you assisted Sergeant Dashhound in like kind of defending the flank, and then provided support to the front lines. Where's your mind at during this final confrontation with whatever this thing is?
Fryon's still really on edge, because I think he's probably the only one that fully gauges what an Aboleth can actually do. and we're not even at the Aboleth yet. So
right, and in fact, if you'll recall, this creature had said that the Aboleth was no longer here, that he had gotten what he came for and left, and that he'd left him in charge.
That's not a thing that one likes to hear. Wild Aboleth has escaped from where we knew it was, and now it's rampaging off God knows where.
Yeah, absolutely. Whatever the task that it had set before it had been completed, which is, of course, not a great sign. Kree, what about you? You probably have, like, been the most injured sans the lightning bolt that hit Hannibal Square in the face just a few moments ago. How are you feeling currently? I believe that your magic is also coming to an end quite shortly. With your bats, which were of great assistance in the fight, because they were able to waylay a lot of the fishermen at once.
Kree's very antsy. This feels like a place that the Aboleth would be, but it doesn't seem that it's actually here. And instead, this creature that's been casting magic and talking about his own creations from his god, as if they're just something to observe or subjects to experiment with, and it's kind of putting him off kilter.
Sure.
He wants to kill this thing. He wants it gone.
For obvious reasons. That makes sense.
Obvious.
Alright, cool. Aelin, what about you? During the battle, I think that you were mostly supporting Sergeant Dashhound as the others went and did their thing, if I recall correctly. But you also did a great job at some of your more defensive maneuvers, like using your gem and all that other cool stuff. So what's Aelin feeling at this? And I'll remind you that, like, the religious undertones here, having only affected you and Morella and Sergeant Dashhound, and Kree to a degree, there's something akin to that going on here that you have definitely picked up on. Also, you have additional information that the party doesn't, because you haven't told them yet.
Correct. I get a lot on my mind, apparently. Yeah, I mean, I feel like, especially with, you know, what transpired at the very end of last session, I feel like she is definitely trying to figure out why that connection is or where that's coming from. But also she has two priorities of trying to get Morella the hell out of the water before any of her visions come true. Everyone out of the water, for that matter, should I keep them away from it. But also she just saw Hannibal get fried and realized he mustn't be on much health. So her healing instincts kick in. So
okay.
So she's currently at the moment.
Cool.
I think.
Cool. And what about you, Arkady? Arkady, you provided your atypical ranged or massive damage spiky attacks from the shadows, as you do. But it was also the first time that you kind of fell into a little bit of danger in quite a while. This thing has AoE spells where hiding from it doesn't really matter. It can still kind of reach out and touch you even if it can't see you, and I don't know how your character may be feeling about that at all, if anything.
I mean, I may have forgotten to record damage, but I've still got myself at full health. So
yes.
At the moment, he still feels like this is something that he's got under control.
Okay, okay. Yeah, no, the Mind Blast,
at the same time,
you
of course,
succeeded, but...
Although, of course, at the same time, the fact that it has an impenetrable shield that no one has yet figured out any way of breaking through is concerning him a little bit, and magic is one of his few areas of non-expertise. That's why he has Farron.
Right.
So he's a little bit wondering what we're going to do now that the obvious problem of the things outside the invincible bubble seems to have been solved.
The things that you can stab are no more, and so what do you do now? Cool.
Yep.
Cool. Yeah. So let's get a gauge real quick of where everybody is on the map. So I'm gonna move everybody over to here. So I've been removing bodies, obviously, from this so that we don't get all caught up in how many dead fishmen there are all over the place. But this is the bubble. We are, and I should probably put this up, actually. What will be my token for this? Always, it's always the... it's always this. There we go. Alright, and this is turn... for my own benefit as well, because I almost forgot. This is turn 7, technically. Oops, it doesn't go there. It goes there. Okay. So, it is... this creature went, and then Hannibal went. Or this creature went, and then Hannibal, teleported to the top of the dome. Hannibal didn't give me a whole lot of instruction as what to do with his character, so I'm going to play him as I know Hannibal best. And I think that for now we're going to kind of go into initiative just in more of the sense that we're going to be taking turns and asking what people are doing in an attempt to defeat this thing. So let me pull up his thing. He has tried most of everything that he has. And so I don't know exactly what he has left that he would even attempt to accomplish here. Let's pull up his character sheet. So, he has currently used... why does he have... what is he doing? Why does he have 300 out of 23 spell? What the hell is this guy doing? Okay. He has one current spell slot remaining out of his two. Jackson does weird stuff with his character sheet. So he doesn't have a whole lot of things, I think, that will be super effective in this situation. So I think that... well, that's an interesting option. I think he's got to hold it for Hex, so he won't be using that. I'm not sure what his plan was getting up on this bubble. But I think that he will probably take the dodge action in case the creature attempts to lightning bolt him again. Seems the best for him. Farron, what's your action that you would complete upcoming here?
Now, me and Arcady, we're kind of taking the kind of sniping spots. I think he will probably just let an arrow loose just to recheck the barrier.
Okay. So you send an arrow sailing?
Yeah.
Sure, go ahead and roll it for me.
Alright.
Okay. So the arrow flies, weaving its way in between the bats, and it strikes the barrier, and we can see the ripple that kind of goes out. Although it seems to stay there for just slightly longer than normal before the arrow falls into the water. It seems like something is changing about the barrier's composition, perhaps. And you notice that this guy inside, he notices that too. As he kind of, looks at it, his facial features are completely inhuman, so he can't read them, but he definitely looks at it, at what happens, and then turns his attention back towards the group of people. Is that it, Farron? Are you going to move, or...?
I think I'm in a good spot where I am.
Okay.
Yeah, that's it for the time being, because just... now, what the hell are we gonna do about this barrier?
Aelin, Ash River.
I think I'm just gonna move up a slight bit, so I'm not on this bridge anymore. And then I think that I would yell to Morella to kindly, at her earliest convenience, get up on that bridge near her and to get out of the water before the barrier comes down, in which I would hint to Farron and Arcadi and anybody else who could hear me that it should be soon that that comes down, so be prepared. Okay. And I'm also going to... Actually, no. I'm not going to do anything else. I'm going to hold that until I see what else happens. I think that I would just dodge for now, if we're talking mechanically speaking.
Mm-hmm. No problem. Knocked.
So, you'll be very happy to know that I have fixed all of my issues with sight. But Noct is just gonna sit here and stare very angrily.
So you can actually see dynamic or not see through dynamic lighting anymore?
Yeah, no kidding. Like, I can actually move around and it affects me now.
That's good. That's good.
It's great. It's fantastic.
Okay. Yeah.
So, Noct is just being angry.
Okay. Dane is going to continue banging on the fishbowl from different locations. Morella?
Yes.
What are you going to do, Morella?
So, more ship went down, right? Well, probably, most likely. I'm probably going to swim and then climb up.
Okay, yeah. Get up on the stone part of the bridge. Seems good. Yep.
And then... Well, I'm going to keep doing what I've been doing for the last, like, what? 3 rounds of combat and try to keep breaking this stupid fucking bubble.
Yep, so, indeed.
So, the whole stab is going to happen.
Okay. Stab away.
So, alrighty. I'm pretty sure I still have my thing up, so.
Why? What is this new message from Roll 20?
Yeah, I know, I saw that. I was like, what?
What?
So strange.
Okay.
Which message? Does anyone have video chat enabled?
No, I mean, I certainly hope not.
No.
Huh. Interesting. Okay, then. So, yeah, no, you hit the barrier and you're pounding it, and you see it do it shimmers every time, every strike that takes it. And Morella, it feels a little bit softer than the hard kind of almost repelling nature of it before.
Here's a quick question.
Mm-hmm.
Could I use my shield to bash against the thing?
Sure.
Okay. So, I'm just going to make an athletics, and whatever happens, happens.
Mm-hmm.
So, how does that happen?
I mean, like, physically, what does it look like when you're bashing the thing with your shield? I don't know, you tell me.
I mean, I imagine it's just me smacking against a wall every time I do this. So,
that's a good representation of what just occurred, yes.
Yeah, so... I mean, whether that has actual any effect or not, doesn't really matter. I'm just keep hitting this fucking thing as hard as I can.
Trying to bash it down.
Yep. I was hoping that you would have made a character sheet just for the barrier and then have to make an athletic
throw. Yeah, totally. And then he'd knock it prone. Yep, absolutely.
Yeah, of course.
You can see this guy in here. He probably looks at you and shakes his head slightly and he's like, brute force tactics. They've never been effective against me. And then we move on to Sergeant Dashhound, who is going to continue her fervent charge into range to assist Morella and also carry a torch, because that's probably important. So this is turn number 8. Arkady Petrov.
Yep.
How would you conduct yourself? This creature has, like, begun attacking you. You've been informed that the barrier may drop shortly. But for now, it appears to still be active and just as impenetrable as it was before.
Yeah, and he's pretty much okay with letting the others try to solve that because he has absolutely zero idea of what he can contribute. So cunning action to hide if necessary, and I think he's just going to ready an action to try to put an arrow in that thing the moment the shield falls, if they do succeed in some way.
Yeah, if I remember correctly, your current stealth is a 31. Would you like to keep that, or would you like to reroll?
No, that's decent.
Okay, alright. Excellent. So you're going to ready an action. If the barrier drops, you shoot him. That is what I heard?
That is correct.
Okay, fantastic. Kree.
So, Kree's actually going to do the exact same thing. He's going to pull out and knock his longbow and just ready an arrow if it drops.
Okay, cool.
And, you know, bats are all attacking the orb.
Yeah,
just lots of pitter-pattering. Just to, it's like tapping on a fishbowl. That's basically what they're doing.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. All right, and that's what they do. So it is his turn. So with his, let's see. This is where decision time comes for him. He certainly has a lot of things that he could attempt to do here.
Come at me, bro.
I think that. Okay. So I think that I'm going to roll this, and I'm just testing a recharge. Okay. Which I should have been doing every turn, but, you know, I didn't. So what he's going to do is he's going to take a few steps back. Is that what he's going to do for reals? Yeah, he's going to take a few steps back. And then he's going to gaze towards you, Mirella, and Sergeant Dashhound. He's going to hold one hand up to his temple. He's going to hold his other hand out. And he's going to cast Mind Blast again.
Oh, well, fuck me.
So if you guys can make me an intelligence saving throw, please.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I did name her Bridget. Okay. Intelligence saving throw. Nope. She does not pass.
Great. Nope.
Nope.
Okay. So, you take a damage and are stunned for 1 minute. You get to repeat the saving throw at the end of each of your turns to end the effect. So, takes a hefty amount of damage to each of you. And you are each stunned for the duration. And then, we see him. What's a good stunned?
I'm just going to make a concentration save in the meantime.
Oh, true. You do have to make that.
It's above 20. It's a DC of what? 13?
13.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I'm fine.
Mm-hmm. No problem. So, as if on cue, we see the barrier when he does this mind blast. It kind of shimmers a little bit, and we probably the first thing we notice is Hannibal, who's like standing on top of it. We see him like shake, and then I think to everyone's surprise, we see him begin to tumble to the ground.
Oh boy!
And I'm gonna roll a since I said it was 10 feet, I'm gonna roll a single dexterity saving throw to see if he takes damage and falls prone or not. But the barrier, having allotted its 1 minute of duration, is no longer there. And we'll roll the thing for Hannibal, and then those of you that have the readied actions can totally use your readied actions. That is a con save. That's not what I wanted to do. Nope, he fails a dexterity save, so he's going to take an extra d6 damage and be prone. It's good. It's good. And be prone. Okay. So, Kree and Arkady, you guys have your readied actions. Technically, he is within 5 feet of an ally, Arkady, but you're also hidden from him, so...
Yep.
All right.
It's the speed of arrows.
And so as the arrows fly out to strike him, and both strike him indeed, we hear a he kind of like, we hear the cavern kind of rumbles a little bit with his hissing, and he says, "You dare strike me with your puny bows?" And that is his turn. So Hannibal, Hannibal is, what is he going to do here? I think that he's going to stand up, and he's going to cast his Hex, because that's the best thing he can do in this instance, I think. Spells. Oh, his Hex is already active. Oh, but he lost it when he failed a Constitution save, because it is a concentration spell, so he does have to cast it again. Okay. So he hexes the target. We're going to say dexterity. Does that sound good to everybody?
Sure. Yeah.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Okay. And I don't think Hannibal's going to do anything else, because he's kind of in a precarious position here. Because he can't really run away. He'll get attacked, and he's already kind of low health as well, so.
I mean, he can always just take the dodge action.
Hex is a bonus action. Wait, he can totally disengage. Never mind. He would totally disengage and move over there. There we go. Well, let's move him here so he has cover.
Yeah, he's a bit...
Okay.
He's that type of person.
Fantastic. That brings us to Farron McKibe. The wall is down, Farron.
Oh, yes.
He appears vulnerable, but angry. Also, the two arrows that struck him don't appear to have done a whole lot.
Kapow. I'm still throwing my arrows at him.
Absolutely. Absolutely. You guys begin the slow descent into attempting to whittle down his hit points. And again, the arrows are striking him. They're dealing damage to him, but does not appear to be hurting him probably as much as you would like in particular. I'm sure that you guys would rather be, you know, hitting him in the head and killing him in one shot. But he appears to be quite the sturdy creature.
Yes.
Anything else for Farron?
Don't go dying on us there, Hannibal. So you can have an extra knife.
Okay. An extra 9 hit points for Hannibal. I will add those to his total HP. Aelin Ashriver.
Well, there are...
I should mention one thing to you.
Sure.
With the collapse of the barrier,
uh-huh,
you find that feeling of heavy weight coming from your spell focus has been relieved. Whatever appears to have been powering that spell or magic appears to have moved on. In fact, it might lead you to believe that this thing may not have even been powering it.
Oh, I'm well certain that was true, but that's fine.
Yeah.
Now, it confirms my suspicion.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right, well, I have three allies who are in need of healing, and I'm going to...
Quite a few allies, yep.
Bump it up a bit, so...
Technically Hannibal. Four if you count Kree.
True. I don't think I can reach Kree. Sorry, buddy. Hannibal, Marilla, and Bridget.
Okay. Does that have a range? You might have to move, actually, to get that.
Yeah, I just did my little...
Oh, hey, look at that. You're just at the edge of the range.
I know. It's like I moved there on purpose.
Perfect.
So, is that a...
It's technically 15, or 16 for everybody.
That's 16 for everybody.
Okay,
so. Oof, the big spells. They're a-coming. Ooh, and I should add 16 to Bridget.
No way. Now that the barrier's down, I'm going to stand here stunned for the next, like, 4 to 6 rounds of combat.
Mm-hmm.
Don't worry.
Seems right, correct.
Yep.
What's Noct gonna do? I'm sorry, Aelin, did you want to move?
No, I'm good.
Okay.
Noct is going to jump in the water and start swimming.
God, why?
Because we love water.
Noct prefers earth, but yes.
Actually, no, it's swimming, so it's a little bit before that. Huh? Okay.
Silly bats.
That's that. Stupid bats, they're all in the way.
It's okay, I think they're up for, what, 2 more rounds?
Yep, 2 more rounds.
Okay. Alright. Is that it for Noct?
That is it for Noct.
Okay. As usual, Dane will do his assistance for Hannibal. By assisting tremendously with his tremendous assistance. Which brings us to Marilla. Marilla, you can go ahead and make that intelligence saving throw because you can't do anything else.
Yep. Oh.
Marilla, you are still stunned.
I was helping.
Sergeant Dashhound is going to make a intelligence saving throw. God, no.
Whoa.
Wow.
Nope, she's stunned as hell. Bring us to round number 9. Arcadi. You finally have free reign to attack this creature. Technically, Dane is an ally.
Okay, so I suppose shooting means I'm no longer hidden, but that's great. If Dane counts as an ally, I can shoot then.
Yeah, you would have to hide first if you wanted to do your hide and then shoot thing.
Right, to have advantage, but...
Right,
yeah.
Right. Well, yeah, because...
I can still get the sneak attack just from this.
Correct. Yep. 100%. Oof.
Oh my god, so many dice and they all hate me.
Alright. Again...
That is borderline minimum damage.
He's... The pincushion effect is occurring. And, like, they're catching and sticking, and then he's, like, either ripping them off, or, like, they're hitting him, but, like, only scratching him. He appears to be quite resilient to your current hail of barrage of absolute maddening.
Well, I mean, arrows. That's great for him, but this is all Arcadi's got right now. Magic is not his thing. So, I suppose stealth again to hide behind this convenient post.
Go ahead and roll it for me, because he does have quite a high perception. Holy shit. Well, you rolled 33.
God. How high is his perception, well, Jordan?
Technically, he would not be able to get you with that one.
Technically.
You are out of the range on that one. Congratulations.
Thank you.
So... What is he gonna... Which one is he gonna do here? Oh, it's not his turn yet, though. Kree.
I guess he's not concentrating on anything.
He is not, no. Not
well,
yet, anyway.
Just keep it that way.
Not yet, anyway.
Oh, just wait, boys. Another bubble's gonna happen.
Kree is going to put away his longbow and start strapping on his shield.
Okay, you spend your action to put your shield on?
Yes.
Okay, cool. Absolutely. So... that is that your turn then? Do the bats want to begin assaulting?
Of course.
All right. Bring them in.
Stupid bats.
They fly into a rage.
Mm-hmm. I fly into a rage.
Those episodes were too damn good.
So that's five that can actually attack him?
Yeah. I would say perhaps six, because one could probably be above.
Okay.
The elevation wise.
There we go.
That'll work. He awaits the onslaught from said bats. Well, that one's not gonna hit. Well, that second one's not gonna hit either. Oh, there we go. Okay, so you have a total of one hit.
For an amazing 7 damage.
Hey, the bats. No one said the bats are going to kill anything.
Distractions.
Yeah, they're just distractions. It's absolutely correct.
Big ass fucking annoying ass distractions.
Yeah, and so they're just like fluttering all around. It's actually probably hard to see him behind all of the like bats who are fluttering and all the other craziness going on. Which may change what he decides to do. So he's fully aware of like who does this. So it's really all about how he wants to deal with that. How does he want to deal with that? I think that a good option here. Does this do anything against that? Hold on. Has no damage component, so technically it would not make you roll. Let us see. I guess. Let's not forget, I'm gonna roll for my recharge. Hey, well that might solve it right there, won't it? So, he turns towards you, Kree, or in your general direction, and is going to use his Mind Blast again. Which is probably going to catch, like, these two bats, and you, and Nacht.
Bring it!
Alright. Not at the greatest of damages. But I do need an intelligence save. Who is that that has minus 4? Is that Nacht?
No, those are the bats.
Oh, nice.
One of those bats are fucking headstrong.
Well, one of them is just good. The other one takes 18 damage, though.
And this is Nacht.
No.
Except he has advantage, because he sees me.
Okay. It's all saving throws that he gets advantage on?
It's all saving throws, nice. But I'm fucked.
You are I'm fucked, boned, though. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So you take 18 psychic damage, and you are stunned for 1 minute, as is one of the bats.
That's fine. I'm just going to delete the bat.
Okay.
All He's right. gone.
That works.
He actually just died.
Okay. And after he does that, you hear him, like, screaming with this weird hissing, kind of gurgling sound as he begins to, like, flail about and keep these bats off of him as best he can. Seems to be distracting him for now, which leaves Hannibal D. Solomon, who does not have any more spell slots, but can obviously Eldritch Blast the heck out of this thing.
Pew 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 pew.
I think we just do it twice. First one misses. Second one hits. Oh no, the first one hits because he has advantage because it's Dane, actually. Dealing a significant amount of damage. And that seemed to definitely hit him fairly hard. The second one also hits. And this creature appears to be receiving some injuries from that. I don't know if Hannibal would actually knock him farther away. What do you guys think?
I mean, Jackson Woods, but...
That's probably not a good idea, right?
Yeah.
That's fine. We can play Jackson's character smarter now that he's not here. So that brings us to Farron McKibe. The way is open.
It is.
The path is lit.
Still haven't got me to face against any people to play on.
It's true. It's true. Not by choice, mind you.
Seeing as how arrows aren't doing the best of things, let's see how... let's try and have another epic spell battle. So, what's brown and sticky? Stick.
Wait, what?
I mean, I really hope you're casting Shalala, because that would be amazing, but...
So I'll make a wisdom saving throw, or fall prone and incapacitated and cannot get up till the end of my next turn. Yeah, I think that's okay. We passed. Barely, but we passed.
Well, okay. I'm not high enough level to do spells and attack, so...
Soon, DM.
Yes, soon to you.
Okay. Is that it for you, Farron?
Yeah, apart from...
Actually, I just realized...
Yeah, because I can't cast spells.
Kree, roll me a constitution saving throw. You took damage.
Okay.
That was the whole point of me attacking you.
For the bats, right, right.
That was literally the only reason why I attacked you. You're fine.
Yeah, they're fine.
Okay, cool. Sorry, I skipped you, Aelin. Aelin, it's your turn. Your friends seem in a bit better now. Kree's taking a little more damage. Sergeant Dashhound is taking a bit of damage.
Yeah. I am considering... I will do this one. Considering God knows how long Morella will be stunned for.
Okay, you're going to cast Sanctuary on Morella?
Yep.
I think you do have to move to get that one in range, though.
I did that backwards. Hold on, my roll 20 just froze completely, so hold on a second.
Words.
Unless you were going to attempt to dive into the water. Megan?
Hold on, my roll 20 froze. I'm bringing everything back up.
Oh, okay. I thought you were also ignoring us.
Why do you do this roll 20?
Okay, it's all back. I figured it out. Okay, wait, if I move to here, it's out of range still?
Yeah, so it's 30 feet. You'd have to get to this square right here.
Okay, well... Never mind, just kidding.
I'm good, don't worry. It's not like this thing could just totally one-shot me. I mean, if he could, that'd be impressive. And then you should all be running.
Yeah. Yep. Mm-hmm. You don't have that much health.
I mean... No, but, like, it doing nearly, 150 damage on one thing would be a damn impressive feat.
Alright, then I have a question. Can it hear me from where I am if I yell?
Yeah, totally.
Okay. Then I'm going to step forward all the way to the edge of the whatever this is.
Mm-hmm.
The bankment. And try to reason with the creature. I'm going to yell to him and say that we can stop this now. It doesn't have to end this way. And see if it gets its attention.
Okay. I'm going to roll a perception check for him. He's a little preoccupied with a lot of bats. He rolled a 19, though, so he probably does hear you. And he probably says, "Bah! Your friends would not think the same, priestess. Plus, you're all my subjects anyway. Why should I reason with you?"
I could convince them. I promise you. You could walk away. We could both walk away as long as you promised to never come back here.
He probably, like, there's a moment where, like, you guys lock eyes.
Not in her mind.
Right, in her mind, it's totally obvious. There's probably a moment where you lock eyes with the creature. And he probably's got, like, a couple scratches, like, down his face from these bats that are fluttering all around him. Roll me an insight check.
I think I'm gonna use my inspiration.
Mm-hmm.
This is important. Nope.
So he locks eyes with you, and you can see there's maybe like a momentary flash of like a little bit of desperation, right? Because he's, like, being assaulted by bats from all around him, and his response to you is, "Then call off your dogs. We shall see how truthful you indeed are."
Yeah, so Aelin would turn to her friends, and probably she could cast light on herself to give herself more attention to them all. And just shout, "Please, friends, a brief moment of respite, please. Hear it out."
Okay. Well, you guys heard what she said. Knocked.
So, Knock didn't really understand her, but then again, he also, doesn't like being in the water too much, since he is an earth lizard. So he's just going to try and get up on land.
Mm-hmm.
And absolutely. That's what he does.
Okay.
And then he will dodge. Yeah. Because, you know, swimming isn't an action. Which I forgot about.
Yeah. Correct, yes. I had assumed you dodged anyway.
Thank you. So nice.
I know. Remember, I do these things because I love you. So Dane... what does Dane do? What does Hannibal think Dane's going to do here? I have two minds. Either have Dane ready in action to shoot the thing if things go sideways, or continue to pummel this thing into oblivion with a help action. But I don't think that's Dane's decision. So we'll go to Mirella. So Mirella, roll the check, which happens at the end of your turn. You good?
Oh my god, I actually did it.
So you are no longer stunned. Sergeant Dashhound will roll hers. She is also no longer stunned.
Fuck her, vibe's cooler.
Making it turn number 10. Arkady Petrov. You heard the creature tell Aelin to call off her dogs. What are you going to do?
I resent both being called a dog and called one of his subjects.
Uh-huh.
So, there is... do I think there's any place I could effectively hide closer to him, like behind one of these posts?
Yeah, those posts do block line of sight. Like, you could do that, or you could go, like, maybe under the bridge. If you wanted to, right? To be out of his sight.
Yeah, okay.
That might be another option for you.
Then, yes, Arkady will reposition.
Okay. Remember that swimming is difficult terrain.
Oh, right. That's... How deep is that water?
So the water's not deep enough that you would have to, like, actually swim, but the water itself causes difficult terrain. So you just get half your movement inside of it.
So to dash...
Oh, well, that's fine. I just double dash.
Okay, yeah. So if you just want to double dash, it's totally a thing that you can do. And you'd be just hanging from underneath the bridge, or under the bridge even, however you want to play it there. Cool.
Pretty much, yeah. And he will stay there.
All right. Kree, if you would be so kind as to roll me an intelligence saving throw. Nope. You are still stunned, sir.
Yeah, very stunned.
And I believe that that's the last turn the bats are active, correct?
This is the last turn they're active, so
okay.
Yes.
So you cast them on turn two?
Yeah.
All right. It gets to his turn. This is where things are probably going to get a little weird, because he
oh,
is...
Oh, would they still attack?
Yeah, that's my thing, is would they still attack him?
No, they're just gone.
Yeah,
they're gone.
I thought you had cast it
actually,
on turn
no,
one
no,
anyway.
Yeah, I did, but they didn't come in till turn two. Because that's how we're doing it.
Well, no, you rolled immediately for their
yeah.
initiative. So technically the spell's been active for 10 rounds.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, so I think they are actually just gone right now.
Perfect.
So, have fun deleting bats. So it's his turn, and you appear to be keeping your word. And so he is simply going to, that seems too obvious. He'll ready in action in case anything happens. And seeing the bats kind of vanish from his vision, He's going to take a few steps back to, like, here. And he is going to call out to Aelin, good, that is the first step. Now, the rest of them, and he kind of, like, motions for everybody else to, stop, you know, like, bull rushing him.
I promised. We will keep our word. We just want to protect this city.
I think you see what might be a smile from his alien-looking face. And he says, good. Then our goals align. I wish to protect the city as well. Perhaps make it even more profitable, fortuitous.
From what do you have to prosper?
Well, I know that in your lands, coin goes a long way. It represents power to most. Power is important.
To some.
To those who rule.
This is true, but not to the common folk, in which you are ruining their lives currently.
From your perception, perhaps. Who is to say they're not being made better?
Indeed, it is all about perception. But again, we are keeping our word. This can end well.
Okay. So I think that he kind of like, again, his eyes are scanning. He seems ready to snap if need be. Which brings us to Hannibal D. Solomons. Hannibal seems like the kind of guy who would like be bold and perhaps go to here. And kind of like eye the creature and ready in action. Which brings us to Farron.
Yeah, I call out. Well, there's one that was made to breathe in the water by your dear master. I can say that it is not something that I would want, and I'm sure the other common folk will attest to that as I knock an arrow into my bow.
Okay. Yeah, and I think he kind of gives that low, like, gurgling laugh, and he says, "You give up the master's gift so easily."
God, such a good thing that Kree is currently stunned.
Perhaps there is merit to what you say, that not all wish to live in the water. I myself do not come of it, but it is something you can get used to. There are certainly more of it than land.
Yet, the common folk will not readily leave their homes and loved ones just because you say it will be more beneficial to them.
I think his eyes widen a little bit and he says, "And this you know, you've spoken with them, you've walked among them, seen their plight." Pity. Clearly your eyes do not work as well as you think. These people are in desperation. I have given them purpose.
Then I guess a mere creature as yourself does not understand the tenacity of human desires for their homes.
And I think he says, "But you, most of all, should understand that there are not just humans."
Aye, but most have the same desire for their own home, just as the humans do.